In this quick video, I'm going to show how you can do the line string kind of cross sections like we used to do in SS10. It's not a feature in Open Roads Designer. It's changed a little bit, but what you want to do is you want to use the size of the scale cross sections that you want to create. So in the case that we have 5, 10, and 20 scale, we have 70 foot offsets for the 5 scale, 140 foot offsets each side for the 10 scale, and then 280 for the 20 scale. So keep that in mind. And what I did is I just arbitrarily drew some lines out here at 140 feet each one, and they're not even perpendicular. I just threw them out there so I could get the idea across to you. So what you want to do is get your pattern lines placed. Okay, so I have them out here, and I've used the 10 scale, so 140 foot on each one of these. Then you go back up to your drawing production tab, and you'll navigate to your name boundary tool. Right now I have no name boundaries in here. And you must have your 2D and your 3D open for this all to work. So when I hit the name boundary, I select the option all the way down. It is a civil cross-section 2-point. Okay, I'm going to leave my dialogues unchecked out here. And then I gave it a tighter clearance. I wanted to fit more in there, so I made it 10 and 5, and 5. That way I get a little bit of room between each one. And I could probably fit all three of these lines that I have out here on one sheet. Okay, my scale is 10 scale. I don't have a group yet. So what I want to do is I want to identify the path. So I'm going to come down and I'll pick my center line. Okay, now it wants me to pick the left side or right side, whichever way. But you'll pick them, and then we'll go ahead and accept it. Now, it wants to do the second one, so I'll go out and I'll pick the path again. And I'll pick. And the important part is that you change it to the group to match what you made on your first one, which would be the group Route 54 that I have. And then you go place the other one as well. And then you'll do accept it after you get your 2 points. And then identify the path one more time for this last one I have down here. And then you'll pick your 2 points of that line that's 140 foot long. And then accept it one more time. So now you can see over in the 3D view, we've got 1, 2, 3 name boundaries of where I want my cross sections cut. Okay, I'm finished with this tool. I can close out of it, get the F4 key. Okay, good there. Now we go to the name boundary manager. This little button on the top of the name boundary, I'll select it. And when I open up my cross section group, see there's one in here with three different cross sections in here. So I can select my group, make sure my create drawing dialog is set on so I can change or add my grid and annotation to it, and then I can process or create the cross section drawings. So when I do this, I'll go down, and the only thing I really need to change is this annotation group. And I will give it on this one, I'll just give it the majors. So annotation with major grid. And then I'll open it to the last sheet model it creates. Hit the OK button. Go to process. Voila, there we have the cross section sheets. Now, looks like maybe I could have used a little bit more grid work in there if I want to get my annotations in there a little better, a little tighter. But that's what it does. It will use that. Now, it's not the same as what it was with the old SS10 where you could just select all the lines and then process them all at once. It's not that way anymore. Kind of a bummer, but this still works pretty much the same way. You just have to pick them individually. And if you don't have a station range that you want to collect, then this would be the way to go. And you can see that three drawing models were created. Open them up and see my drawing models. Put some notes in here if I want to or whatever I need. And then again, I'm back to that sheet model. And it looks pretty good. Seems like it turned out really well. That's how you would do it.